I'm Justin Benny. I'm going to start with a number tonight. It has nothing to do with COVID-19. $31,440.02. That's about how much money Rhinelander police say was stolen from the city of Rhinelander by H&H Septic over the last 6 years. Police say a city employee let it happen. NewsWatch 12's Dan Hagen joins us now live in studio with the details on this investigation. Dan, good evening.
Good evening, Justin. We will get to that investigation done by the Rhinelander Police Department in just a moment. First, I want to establish a shared language of how the septic disposal process works. H&H Septic is a local disposal company that, among other things, picks up septic waste from houses and businesses and transports it to the Rhinelander Wastewater Treatment Plant. It costs money for the plant to treat the wastewater, so it charges H&H Septic to drop off the septic it collects. Now to perhaps the most crucial part. At this point, H&H has to log what type of septic they're dropping off. It's commonly either called holding tank or called septage. Holding tank is mostly water, so it doesn't require much treatment by the plant. It costs $24.50 per 1,000 gallons. Septage has more solid waste in it and requires much more treatment by the plant, so it costs more to drop off, around $60 per 1,000 gallons. Rhinelander police say H&H Septic for years routinely logged holding tank when really it was depositing septage. They did it so often, the city lost over $30,000. And the person who police say let H&H get away with it was Tim Kingman, a city employee.
At first glance, the relationship between H&H Septic and the Rhinelander Wastewater Treatment Plant may seem like preferential treatment.
H&H was dumping on the weekends when other septic companies were not allowed to.
But dig a little deeper, and it's clear H&H Septic was stealing thousands of dollars from the city of Rhinelander. Detective Sergeant Kyle Parrish was first alerted to possible theft in the spring of 2019. A treatment plant employee who will go unnamed noticed fresh tire tracks in the snow going up to the septage receiving station. It was the weekend and septic wasn't allowed to be dropped off on weekends. The employee checked the log and observed no entries by any septic companies. But a short time later, the employee in question received a text message from Stephen Vick, the owner of H&H Septic. The text read, "I was the one at that dump at that plant. Steve, get my drift." Investigating further, Parrish observed a series of dishonest actions stretching back 6 years. The two major transgressions by H&H were logging incorrect amounts of septic, even sometimes not logging anything, and incorrectly logging holding tank instead of septage. Holding tank costs significantly less money to H&H.
When you're dumping thousands and thousands of gallons a day, it doesn't take long to add up.
Police say all of this was made possible by Rhinelander Public Works Director Tim Kingman, who is friends with Stephen Vick and enlisted Stephen's son Bradley as his right-hand man at the plant. Tim Kingman's two main transgressions were allowing H&H all hours access to the plant by giving them the gate code while ignoring his employees' complaints that H&H trucks appeared after hours, and changing the amount of septic waste dropped off by H&H in the internal billing system. When confronted by Detective Parrish about this, Kingman claimed he unwittingly made errors in the system, saying, "If I made an error, that's what I did." But then why did his actions only benefit H&H and not other septic companies like A1 Septic?
The error rate for A1 was significantly lower than for H&H. And it just, if you're going to continuously make errors, we just found it unusual that it was only for one company that seemed to benefit from it.
Parrish approximated H&H stole $31,440.02 from the city of Rhinelander. The Oneida County District Attorney did not prosecute Stephen Vick or Tim Kingman. Instead, a plea agreement was reached, and H&H had to repay the city a little over $4,000. Mayor Chris Fredrickson noted the large difference in the amount stolen by H&H and the amount repaid to the city at this week's city council meeting.
Restitution was paid to the city from H&H Septic in the amount of $4,132. The reason I bring that up is the police record also has a different total for the amount of loss during that time. and the amount of loss during that time was $31,402.02.
That means H&H kept approximately $27,000 of the money it stole from the city.
The city of Rhinelander fired Kingman in 2019. He was accused of creating a hostile work environment for employees of the Public Works Department. He later filed a wrongful termination lawsuit, which is still pending.